For the first time ever, I'm embarrassed to say, this Christmas I watched the Mariinsky Theater's production of The Nutcracker, and I was truly inspired by the beautiful set and costumes to try and recreate the Sugarplum Fairy costume, which is this one right here. It is absolutely stunning, and I had to try and recreate it. Once again, like my previous video, I challenged myself to only use stuff I had at home. Did I make it? Did I fail? I don't know, but you can let me know. So yeah, in this video I will be attempting to recreate the Mariinsky Theater's Sugarplum Fairy costume. I went to Marie Kareva's Instagram to get the footage of how I could recreate it, and this is me attempting to do so. So the first thing I had to figure out was what pink material I had to match my pink tutu. Luckily I did have this stretchy stuff. It had this weird pattern thing, print, I don't know. But that was okay, it would work. I cut a leotard pattern that I had in half, so it was just the bottom half, because I wanted to make the top half like a corset type bodice thing going on. So I cut the bottom half of a leotard pattern, like I said, and sewed it like as if it was a leotard. I had no idea what I was doing, so I just kind of hoped it would work. I added elastic like how you should on the legs and made it like a normal leotard. You're not going to see this anyway because it's going to be covered by the tutu, but that's okay. We want it to fit nicely and make it look nice anyways. So I did all of that and sewed it to be nice and stretchy, and then moved on to the top part. I took a corset pattern and didn't cut it all the way to the bottom because, you know, the bottom half already comes up quite a bit from the, you know, the bottom half of the bottom. And I cut this V part for the bust area because there's a skin colored patch going on over there in the original costume that I'm clearly following. Anyway, so I cut the rest of the top corset pattern part and sewed it together. I did not bother to measure any of it to see if it actually fit with the bottom underwear part piece. So I just kind of hoped that it would. I cut off all this excess material because it's uncomfortable, you know? And then I needed to figure out the size of the piece of skin color material I'm putting there. This was a fail. I'm just going to go out and say it before, you know, you even see it. I folded it in half and thought, you know, I need to cut it bigger because somehow I'm going to need more. No, it just failed. It was too big, too long, but, you know, I fixed it. I saved it. I overlapped it a lot, and that turned out to not really work. So I don't recommend doing that. Yeah, I got left with this weird bubble. But once again, I saved the day. I folded it in half and created an extra seam because there's never enough seams in a corset top type thing. And I sewed it down, and that seemed to have fixed it for the most part. Next, I needed to sew it, or, you know, see if it would actually fit onto the bottom. So I made a halfway mark on the front and back part and put the extra seam, which is now marking the middle, aligned with the mark. And after pinning everything together, I realized it fit perfectly. Weirdly enough, it just absolutely fit perfectly. I got left with about a centimeter at the edge, at the back part, you know, where it has to, you know, fold over, whatever overlap, where you put the buttons or the zipper or something. And that was perfect. Weirdly enough, it turned out to be wonderful. So that was lucky. Don't do that without planning, but if it works out, it works out. Anyways. Yeah, so I then just sewed the top half of the leotard to the bottom half of the leotard, and it turned out perfectly. I was very lucky with that stroke of luck of it fitting. I'm going to deal with the back closure later. For now, we're going to get into the fun part of cutting off all the extra material and then adding all the jewels and sparkles. And no, wait, never mind. We're hemming the top part. So I pinned the top part, of course, and sewed it down. If you sew it with elastic, that'd probably be better. Now we're moving on to the fun part of figuring out how in the world we're going to decorate it to look exactly the same like the one from the Mariinsky Theater. I had this ugly lace, and I cut out all the paisley things that were on it and flowers, and I realized that I could kind of use it because there were like these snowflake things sticking out on the sides of the costume, on the sides, but I mean by like how I have it lined up here, and realized that I could use those ugly flowers for kind of a base. But first I sewed a line of sequins onto the front. It was kind of going diagonally, so I of course just kind of went with that design because that's what I'm trying to recreate.
So the Mariinsky one, obviously, is done by a professional seamstress, and it looks amazing. Mine, well, no comment for now.
God.
Anyway, I then took the lace flowers and sewed it down with a bunch of sequins. I didn't bother to sew it separately down and then put the sequins. I just sewed the sequins onto it because that's just so much faster and easier. I added these like pink and bluish greenish color things just to have a bit of extra color because I don't want it to just be block of silver and gold. I then added on these gold sequins because there were like these weird clumps of gold and clumps of silver. I don't know. And then had a design and then so on this like snowflake icicle looking thing that goes on the side. Later on, I add on an extra one, even though I don't think there was one. I'll get to that later. Anyway, so now we're doing the tutu top. I took a square of tulle, more like a rectangle, and cut a hole in the center. Once again, I measured nothing, and luckily it fit. I got really lucky with this costume. Anyway, I took this see-through tulle-ish type stuff and cut a bunch of stars because there's stars on the tulle tutu skirt cover, whatever. And I painted these stars, yes, with paint, and it wasn't even proper, you know, cloth paint, but that doesn't matter. Painted them gold, and that was a real waste of paint, so definitely don't do that. Probably could have just painted it straight onto the tulle. Anyways, I cut a bunch of triangle shapes as well, and put, since I did not surprisingly have silver paint, I painted on, yeah, I actually painted on glue and then silver sparkles. I had these cute little red beads and a gold sequin and sewed it to the middle because it looked pretty and it needed something, and because there was some gold, I mean, yeah, gold and red thing going on in the center of the star. Couldn't exactly see what it was, so I just kind of made up my own thing that kind of looked similar. Yeah. For the shimmery, sparkly part of the tutu design, I just went ahead and glued straight onto the tulle. Yes, I did do that. I glued it. I glued a design with glue, clearly. And then I sprinkled the sparkles right on top. I'm having a real difficult time saying sprinkle the sparkles. That sounds stupid to my mind now. Anyways, I did that with gold and silver, clearly, and it was a real waste of sparkles, though I somehow managed to save a lot, whatever. It actually turned out okay because it was, you know, dark enough and depthful enough, I guess.
Yeah, so to do the right side, because I had done the left side, I took the glued piece of paper from the left side and then just pressed it onto the right side, but facing the other way, so on top instead of on the bottom. That way it would be the exact same design, and I wouldn't have to try and retrace it, and it really not working out well. So this way it worked out well. It was just a matter of me placing it on the correct spot of the tutu, which I don't think went well, but whatever. It's far away, so you can't really tell. I added more glue to that because it wasn't enough, because tulle does actually have holes in it, and the glue went right through those holes, of course. I added the glitter, of course, after adding the glue, and there was a lot of glitter and glue going on. I added more designs around the sides and then the back. I couldn't really find a lot of footage of what those designs really look like, so I just kind of winged it. You're going to see later on. I sewed all the little tiny silver triangles to the stars. That way they're 10-pointed stars, not 5, to make them extra special. And that's how they turned out. I probably could have just done the glue thing and made the stars out of glitter and glue, like the designs I did on the tulle part, whatever, but, you know, you live and you learn. Anyways, so this is what it looked like with all the stars placed on the tutu. I did not sew them on yet. This is what it looked like with the bodice so far. I then, of course, had to sew on the stars. I just sewed the middle, and then I realized that they kind of flopped around a lot. So then I had to sew down each and every single point on the star, which was very tedious. Anyways, I cut off all the extra tulle because it kind of looked weird, and this is what I got left with. The tulle top of the tutu. Yeah, with all the designs. Anyways, the top bodice part was looking kind of lacking, believe it or not, in my opinion. The way I have it, not the Mariinsky's. That one's beautiful. Anyways, so I sewed on a bunch of extra... I'm losing my ability to talk. Extra star sequins and a couple more gold ones because you never have enough gold or silver. And I did add some extra to the back. Anyways, I am now sewing down or hemming the edging of the back for then putting a closure. That way it's not messy, but it looks nice and neat. But before that, I realized the back looked lacking. I had added those extra star-looking things, but it was still lacking-looking in my opinion. But I went ahead and sewed on the buttons anyways for whatever reason. And then after sewing on the buttons, I realized, yes, it's boring. So what did I do? I found no footage of the back of the costume. So I kind of just recreated the icicle-looking thing, star, sparkle, snowflake thing from before that was on the side and kind of made it smaller and shorter. And it didn't turn out terrible, but I don't love the way it turned out. It could have been better, but it's something. From far away, with this costume, just from far away, it looks okay. Yeah, spacing was not good, but whatever. Next, I had to do the straps, of course. This is all the last I had. It was white, whatever, so I sewed two pieces together to make them stronger, and then I sewed them kind of hidden onto the costume, of course. And that is it for the costume. I did make a tiara and earrings, which I will put in another video because this one is just going to get too long, and I will make that kind of more like a tutorial video, whatever. So yeah, I made a matching tiara and earrings, which are very cute and match. And this is what the costume looks like. This is my TikTok. Please go check it out. Anyways, obviously nothing at all like the Mariinsky one because that one is stunning. But this is my recreation. I'm kind of proud. It kind of turned out well for what I had. It fits, of course, and it's wearable. So yeah, thanks for watching and check out my TikTok.